Can we maybe look through your cupboard?
Yeah. I don't have a lot of really cool stuff here, though, I think.
Oh.
I have so much stuff in, like, back home. But it's... I don't want to, like, get rid of any of it. Because I kind of go back and forth with my clothes. Like, I won't wear something for years, and then I'll rediscover it and then wear that. Mm. And then kind of, like, swap my own clothes so I don't have to buy a lot of new stuff. I just go back and forth with my own clothes.
Yeah.
And I really like kind of, it sounds really corny, but I like when clothes kind of find you. Like if you're at a secondhand shop and something fits perfectly and you're like, this was just waiting for me here. And yeah, I was, something that I was thinking about today, I really like when I'm wearing a certain outfit, sometimes I'll stop and think like, okay, analyze what I'm wearing today and then think of all the stories that I have with all the clothes. And yeah, a lot of stuff is like handed to me or found somewhere or exchanged for something. And I like how some clothes, like, it's because it's easy to go to a shop and buy something.
Mm.
But if if an item of clothing has kind of worked its way to you, then you're like...
Yeah.
And then you have to adapt to the clothes.
Yeah.
And that opens and up you find a way to drawers.
Let it inspire an outfit.
Yeah. Or something. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Fashion for me personally, like personally, if it's about me specifically, then I don't think of dressing myself as fashion. Like for me, it's about clothing, like clothing myself, covering my body. Yeah, it's self-expression and it's how you present yourself to the world. Self-expression is style, it's your style. And the most evident way to express that is by what you wear. Your body is your most immediate environment. Your body is kind of your house in the world. So clothes are your most intimate belongings, I guess. Like, isn't it like Chanel who said, like, trends of fashion is changing, but style is forever or something? When I was a child, my mom says that I was kind of a fashionable child.
Stylish, maybe
stylish, yeah, compared to my sister at least, because I would like match my shirt to my socks and like mix patterns and wear like scarves and berets and I remember being like 8, 9, 10 and having dramas about what I'm gonna wear that day, and piecing together my outfits, and even if it was pouring, and I remember I had these like red shoes with like huge bows on it,
yeah,
and they really went with like my striped stockings and my striped shirt that day, and I was like, no, I'm wearing these shoes today. I guess it's always kind of been part of, yeah, my expression.
Yeah.
I mean, everyone goes through that, like, inconfidence period.
Yeah.
Unconfident period in middle school.
Sure.
There was a period when I really tried to fit in. And then I kind of let go of that and, like, really, like, discovered secondhand and everything.
Yeah.
And started wearing, like, bowler hats and like circle skirts and stuff like that, and kind of, yeah, trying to piece together what I thought was cool. And that was very different to like my friends and stuff like that. When I tried to fit in, it was right after I'd moved back to Europe from Kazakhstan after not having friends for a bit and wearing a school uniform for every day. So I didn't really know how to act like a preteen. So I'd wear like, you know, tights and like really short shorts and like tank tops and things. And sometimes I'd like change at school because my mom wouldn't let me to wear something. So yeah, and those like tube skirts were really in. Rarely I would like change at school, but there were instances, or I mean, I wouldn't pack an entire outfit. I'd wear like parts of my outfit, like, but I'd wear like a tank top and trousers to school, but when I get to school, I change the trousers for shorts or something. After that, I got into bowler hats and, yeah, like secondhand stuff. And
what did that feel like? Did you feel like, did you feel self-conscious about that? Or was it freeing to be able to like now dress the way you wanted?
I do remember thinking like maybe this is a bit weird, but it made me feel cooler. And it made me feel different, and I did get compliments when I dressed different, and that made me feel better, because I was like, oh,
yeah,
it's different, and it's new, and people are open to it. But there were instances when I would get called weird or something like that. But I mean, maybe that just makes you rebel more.
Yeah.
I don't know. I never like went home and like cried like, oh, someone thought it was weird. I felt kind of defiant when I'd wear something. Yeah, like I was like, this is really cool. Maybe. And then someone like calls me weird. I'm like, that's because they're really boring, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was kind of a pride that like, I mean, if someone calls you weird, it means that they've noticed it, yeah. You know? A girl who I ended up being really good friends with, but who was a really bad influence on me, like, yeah, it's the people who wear Abercrombie and Hollister, and
okay.
Yeah, that kind of stuff. Yeah.
And a bad influence in what way?
She was a bad influence because with her I smoked and drank for the first time. I lied to my parents about it,
yeah.
And she like smoked weed and slept with a lot of people, and I mean I don't know if it's a bad influence, it's just an influence.
Yeah.
So, but I mean, looking back, I don't know if I would have done that stuff myself, but yeah, I don't know if it's a bad influence. That's kind of judgmental to say.
Yeah. Like,
but our lives have also ended up in vastly different ways.
Yeah.
So I don't want to be judgmental or anything. Yeah. But
and did you like? Have you always felt like an arty person?
Yeah. Yeah, I've always been an arty person, I think. I mean, it started with just drawing well, but then it turned into like otherwise culture.
Yeah.
Just being interested in culture and yeah, I've definitely out of my friends, generally I've been the arty person. Well, yeah, the way I dressed, when I started wearing like bowler hats and all this stuff, I really discovered literature more. Like I was a big reader as a kid, and then I kind of fell out of it, and then you go back to it and you like rediscover it, and that was kind of 14, 15 when you start reading. Like I was really into it. Like, one of my favorite books still is Revolutionary Road. And this whole like 50s thing. That's where like the circle skirts came from.
Yeah.
And the Great Gatsby, bowler hats, brogues,
oh,
you
amazing.
Know, button ups. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it came from books. And then arty stuff, yeah, it came from patterns and colors and just mixing that kind of stuff. You asked me before if I've ever set any rules for dressing.
Yeah.
There was a period when I tried to dress very minimal, only black and gray and monochrome colors. Now I kind of let go of that.
Yeah.
Evidently.
Do you enjoy dressing yourself in the morning?
Yeah. Yeah, dressing myself has always been really important to me, I think.
Yeah.
Another rule I used to set myself, I mean, I don't like live by it, but I just, doesn't affect me that much. I used to say that I'm never going to leave the house in sweatpants.
Have you ever broken that rule?
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
Break it. You should break it.
I don't know if I have sweatpants.
To be broken.
I don't have sweatpants. That's the thing.
Oh, I see.
I mean, I think once when I left to go to the hospital to get my tonsils out, maybe then. Certain outfits have like a different personality as well, so depending on the day, you have like a different personality or like different character.